Hey, what's up you guys? We're back again with another facts video, and today we're going through 10 facts about the man who was once had the reputation of being called the strongest man in the world, one of the former Yonkos and the former captain of the Whitebeard Pirates, Whitebeard. But before that, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you like this video, and leave a like and follow my FB page for more updates on newer videos. Let's go! So at number 10 is we have his debut. Whitebeard officially made his first appearance in chapter 234 of the manga and episode 151 of the anime. If you remember, Whitebeard was meeting with Rockstar during the chapter, which led him into meeting with Shanks later on, greeting him personally. Interestingly, Whitebeard's first appearance was way before this, back in chapter 159 of the manga and episode 95 of the anime. However, we were only treated to his silhouette, so that doesn't count as a proper debut in the series. Number 9 is we have Whitebeard's birth. Since Whitebeard's past hasn't been completely fleshed out in One Piece yet, it is a given that some fans have missed the origins of Whitebeard. According to Oda, Whitebeard was born on April 6 in the year 1450 in the One Piece world. His place of origin is listed as Sphinx Island in the One Piece Vivre Card data book, and it was revealed canonically that in the story when Nekomamushi went to seek Marco for the War of Wano Country. Surprisingly, Whitebeard was actually 2.3 years younger than the man who was his greatest rival, Gull D. Roger. Number 8 is we have Whitebeard's first crew. Whitebeard wasn't always the captain of the Whitebeard Pirates, and this is something that Eiichiro Oda made sure to emphasize in the series a couple of times. Prior to his death, we got to see a flashback of him and his former crew where he expressed his intentions of having a great family. Later on in the manga, it was revealed that he sailed on the same ship as Rocks D. Sebek, the man who aimed to be the king of the world, as a member of the Rocks Pirates. It was a few years after the God Valley incident that Whitebeard went on to form his own crew. Number 7 is his other nickname. It is a well-known fact that Whitebeard was renowned across the oceans as the strongest man in the world. The fact that nobody was as strong as him was acknowledged by everyone, including the likes of Shanks and even Garp, who called him the King of the Seas. Interestingly, the strongest man in the world wasn't the only epithet that he ever had. Whitebeard was also known as the man closest to One Piece by many. Ironically, this couldn't be further from the truth, as he never wanted the One Piece to begin with, as his only treasure was his family. Number 6 is we have his early childhood. Whitebeard as a kid was an orphan and lived his early days in poverty. This was down to the fact that Sphinx Island couldn't afford to ally themselves with the world government, as they lacked the funds to pay to the heavenly tribute. Consequently, Newgate set out to sea in search of wealth. As we know already, he went on to become one of the greatest pirates that the world has ever seen. According to Marco, Whitebeard's share of treasure always went back to Sphinx Island, since the people there lived a poor quality of life. Number 5 is we have his power. Whitebeard is often considered to be the second greatest pirate after Gull D. Roger, because the latter found the One Piece. Although this certainly is the case, Whitebeard was equal to Roger in every way one could imagine. He simply wasn't interested in finding the One Piece, and for him, his only treasure was his family. Just as Roger found his treasure, Whitebeard found his as well. In terms of power, Whitebeard was known as the only man who have ever matched Gull D. Roger in One Piece. In fact, Whitebeard held the title of the strongest man in the world during Roger's era as well. Number 4 is Whitebeard's love for orphans. As mentioned in the past fact, Whitebeard was born an orphan. Whether he knew his parents or not is something that we don't know. As such, he had first-hand experience of what not having a family felt like. This ultimately became the primary reason for him to recruit orphans on his crew and create a family like no other. As seen in One Piece chapter 965, Whitebeard's sole reason for recruiting Teach on his crew was because he was an orphan and had nowhere to go. This was likely the case for many of the other members of the crew as well, and we all know where this recruiting Teach is going to end up. Number 3. As the rules pirate, Whitebeard had a sense of freedom that others simply did not possess. However, that certainly didn't mean that he didn't have a code to adhere to. Whitebeard had two very intriguing rules that he never broke. The first one was set by him and his crew, and according to the rule, the members of the Whitebeard Pirates were forbidden from ever killing another crew member, a rule that Blackbeard broke. The second rule was something that Whitebeard had set for himself. Whitebeard made sure to never take another person's treasure from them, ever, because he realized what a person's treasure meant to them. As a result, he chose to avoid harming what others considered valuable to them. Number two is his haki. Being the strongest person in One Piece, it's no surprise that Whitebeard was an extremely powerful haki user. It was confirmed by Eiichiro Oda that Whitebeard had the skill to use all three haki types. In One Piece Chapter 966, Whitebeard displayed the ability to use high-level advanced armament and conqueror's haki when he was seen clashing against Roger in the Grand Line. This strong haki of his, when coupled with his Devil Fruit ability, made him the most fearsome pirate on the oceans, especially if his family was harmed. Number 1 is his bounty. Well, before we proceed, you can check my top 15 One Piece bounties video. I'll put the link in the description down below. So Whitebeard's bounty remained unknown for the majority of the One Piece series until Chapter 957, which was titled Ultimate, which dropped earlier this year. After the bounties of the current Yonko were disclosed, Oda revealed the bounties of Whitebeard and Roger to the fans as well. According to what we were told, Whitebeard possessed a bounty of 5 billion and 46 million berries, which is an amount only second to Roger. It is highly likely that Roger's bounty was higher because he found the One Piece and learned the true history, while Whitebeard simply wasn't interested in all of that. Okay, that's all for today's video, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and you learned something. And if you like this video, please don't forget to subscribe to my channel to support me. And please leave a like and share this video as well. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye-ers. Oh, wait, before I leave, don't forget to comment down below the character you want me to do next for a facts video. And I'll see you guys in the next one again. Bye-ers.